How you doing then? All right, are you? Now look, Squire, you're the governor here, I can see that. I'm on your manor now, so there's no need to get your knickers in a twist. Whatever this bollocks is that's going down between you and that slag Valentine, it's got nothing to do with me. I couldn't care less, all right, mate? Let me explain you. When I was in prison, second time, no, tell a lie, third stretch. Yeah, third. There was this screw what really had it in for me, and that geezer was top of my list. 2 years after I got sprung, I sees him in Holland Park. He's sitting on a bench feeding bloody pigeons. There was no one about. I could have gone up behind him and snapped his fucking neck. Wallop. But I left it. I could have nobbled him, but I didn't. Because what I thought I wanted wasn't what I wanted. What I thought I was thinking about was something else. I didn't give a toss. It didn't matter, see? This Burke on the bench wasn't worth my time. It meant sod all in the end. Because you've got to make a choice. When to do something and when to let it go. When it matters and when it don't. Bide your time. That's what prison teaches you, if nothing else. Bide your time and everything becomes clear and you can act accordingly.
There's one thing I don't understand. The thing I don't understand is every motherfucking word you're saying.